Hey, Free Code Camp, and welcome to another The Daily Programmer Web Series video. The problem today we're going to talk about is called Talking Clock, which is number 321. Let's go ahead and look at the subreddit and read through it. All right, so for this problem, the description says, no more hiding from your alarm clock. You decide you want your computer to keep you updated from time to time so you're never late again. A talking clock takes a 24-hour time and translates it into words. So for the input, we're given this type of string. So military time, for instance, we have the string 20:29, which would be 8:29. And then our goal is to take that input string and to print out its string representation. So in this case, 20:29 should print out it's 8:29 p.m. And then for 00, it should print out it's 12 a.m. So if I'm reading the description, just looking at the input data and the output data, it should be pretty straightforward as to what we're trying to do. So let's start breaking this down and implementing it on the whiteboard. All right, so let's look at a single example here where we have 22:35. And the first thing that comes to mind is when you have something like this and you need to kind of process it from, you know, the hours and the minutes, it's useful to kind of extract your hours separate from your minutes. So you can go ahead and split this string on the colon, which will give you an array of 22 and 35 as string form. And then you can convert those to integers using the parseInt method, or, you know, map the array and pass it the parseInt function. But regardless, when you end up with 22 and 35, we're going to be using these to kind of generate these three subproblems. So if you were to look at the main problem that we're trying to solve, there are three different things you kind of have to do, and you could do them separately. So the first one is, how do you print out the hour? So that's like, how do you print out 1 o'clock, 2 o'clock, 3 o'clock to 12 o'clock? How do you print out the minute is subproblem 2, which will be the hardest, and we'll save that one for last. And that would be like, how do you print out, if it's 0505, in this case 35, how do you print out 35 a.m. or p.m.? And then the third subproblem is, how do you print out a.m. or p.m.? And again, since this is military time, 0 is 12 a.m., 12 is 12 noon, which is 12 p.m., and then 23 would be 11 p.m. So out of these three subproblems, let's go ahead and start with the easiest one, which would be print a.m. / p.m. So to do that, this one should be pretty straightforward. So if you were to take the hour representation here, so 22, how would you check if this is in the afternoon or if this is in the morning, like a.m.? Well, basically, if it's less than 12, we know that it should be a.m. Otherwise, it should be p.m. So in this case, 22 would be 10 o'clock at night. So we can just use this if statement to determine if it's a.m. or p.m., and that's pretty straightforward. So in this case, we're going to say it's p.m. Go ahead and write p.m. at the end of our string and save that for later. So we solved the first subproblem, which is how do you determine if it's a.m. or p.m.? Pretty straightforward. And then let's move on to subproblem 1, is how do you print out the hour? So to do this, first we want to declare some type of structure so you can convert the number that we have as the input and determine that the string it needs to be outputted, right? So over here, I went ahead and defined an array which represents the different hours we can print out. So 12, 1, 2, 3, 4, all the way to 11 o'clock. And I'm mapping some index to those. So it turns out that, you know, these are integers and they map pretty well to the indexes of arrays. So I went ahead and just decided to choose an array to kind of figure out the conversion. So to map, let's say, a number 22 to the corresponding number it needs to be over in this hours array, we could simply just mod it by 12, which is the number of hours that you have in each segment of the day, a.m. and p.m. So if you do 22 mod 12, we're left with 10. And then if you use that index 10 and figure out what it needs to be in this hours array, index 10 should point to the string 10. So in this case down here, we could just say, you know, print out hours of 22 mod 12, and that should give us index 10, which would then print out the string 10. I'll just go ahead and start this with its, right? And so if you were to do something else, such as instead of, let's say this wasn't 22 and it said this is 12, we'd be left with the index of 0, which would give us 12. And if the input was, let's say, 0, we're also going to get 0, which is 12, because you remember 00 is 12 a.m., which again will work as we intended to. So that's how you do the subproblem print hours. Pretty straightforward as well. just declare an array where each index of the array points to the string representation of that index, and then just mod your input hours to by 12 to get whatever index you need to print out. So let's move on to the last part of this problem, which is the harder part, which is printing out the minute string. So to start off, there's a couple of different subproblems. The first subproblem for printing the minute is, let's say it's a number that's less than 10, right? Those are single digit numbers. So in this case, let's say this was 05 instead of 35. We need to print out 05. So again, we can still do like the same logic here, but instead of using an hours array, we can go ahead and just use a ones array. And the ones array, same idea as the hours array, but instead of 0 through 11, we have indexes 0 through 9, where 0 is a blank string, 1 is the string 1, etc., until 9, we have the string 9. So in this particular case, how do you print out if, let's say, we had 05 as our input? How would you print out 05 here, right? So if it is less than 10, we know that we need to use this ones array to kind of figure out what the string needs to be. And again, we could just take the digit as our index and print it out here. So in this case, we'd get 05 here, which would be cast to 5 if we parse it as an int. And then our index 5 would just print out 5, and we can prefix with O and then concatenate it with whatever that is. Again, I'll write out the first case, which is if m is less than 10. And again, the first case, if m less than 10, we just need to print out a single digit. The second case, if m is less than 20, we need to print out the teens, right? So 13, 14, 15, 11, 12, whatever. So let's go ahead and declare another array called teens, which we can use to, again, map numbers from 10 to 19 using the same process. So again, this one, once we get m, we're actually going to have to mod it by 10 so that we can get what value it is in this array. So in this case, if m is, let's say, 15, if we mod that by 10, we'll get 5. And then if we look up index 5 in this tens array, or teens array, 5 should equal the string 5. If we try it with, let's say, 10 mod 10, we're going to be left with 0, which will give us 10 as our string. If we mod it by 19 by 10, we're going to be left with index 9, which again over here, 9 is 19. So we solve subproblem if m is less than 10. We solve the subproblem if m is less than 20. Now for the last subproblem is else. So otherwise, it's greater than or equal to 20. Now in this case, we need yet another array, which will be called our tens array. And what this array is used for is printing out the tens digit. So in this case, 35, we need to print out 30. And then we also need to print out 5. So taking that example, let's just go ahead and say, okay, well, how do we print out 30? So we have this tens array over here, indexes 0 through 5. We need to get index 3, right? The digit 3 will represent 30 down here. So to do that, we can just do m divided by 10 and then floor that. And that should leave us with 3 in this case. Index 3 will give us 30. So I'll go ahead and write it's 10:30. And then the last part of this is we need to get the ones digit. So I can say m mod 10. In this case, 35 mod 10 will give us 5. And then if we were to look that up in the ones array over here, we should get the string 5. So if I were to just do that, we can print out 5 here. And that's basically how you'd work out this problem, in this subproblem, where if you were to print out 35, we just use the ones array, we use the tens array, we kind of concatenate them together. We can mod by 10 or divide by 10 to get the different digits. So divide by 10 gives us 3, mod by 10 gives us 5, look those up, and then print them out down here. So finally, the single input 22:35 will give us the output, it's 10:35 p.m. Hopefully this is a good overview of how to break this down into different subproblems. And again, how to break down this subproblem 2, which is print minute, into the different cases that we need to handle. And there's probably a different way to do this, but I think this is the easiest that comes to my mind. All right, so again, let's implement this in JavaScript. All right, so to start off with the implementation, I went ahead and declared those four arrays that are used for mapping the integer value to the string representation. So you see here we have a capital hours array, which has all the 12 through 11. We have the capital ones array, which has all the different ones digits, so 1 through 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. We have the teens array, which is used for mapping all those different cases where we have 10 through 19. And then finally, we have the tens array, which is used for mapping the tens digit of cases that are greater than or equal to 20. And then down here, let's just go ahead and start with the use case of 00, 00, and let's start declaring the function called talk, which takes a time as an input parameter. So the first thing we want to do, again, is take that time string, and we can go ahead and split it, parse the ints, and map it to an array. So I can say const of hm is equal to time of split, and then split it by the colons, and then map it by the parse int function. And then I'll go ahead and return an empty string here just for now. So just to kind of see what's going on here, I'll print out h and m. Those both print out 0, so that's expected. If I were to change this to, let's say, 1 and 1, those both print out 1 and 1. So that's working as intended. So let's first start with the first subproblem, which is how do you print out the hour string? So to do that, remember we have the hours array, which we can grab h from, and then we need to mod it by 12. And then we can say const hour is equal to that. And if I were to print out hour down here, we see that it prints out 12. So we just solved the first subproblem with how do we print out the hours. And you see down here we're printing out 12, which is expected. And then before we take a step forward, I'm just going to go ahead and just print out or start working on an array where we can say its, and then also print out hours. And then I'm going to join those with an empty string. So that's just kind of building up our final string that we're supposed to print as an output. And then the second subproblem is how do you print out the suffix of am and pm? So again, we can say const suffix is equal to, and then I'm going to use a ternary operator here, say h less than 12. Then we need to print out am. Otherwise, we print out pm. And then we can just go ahead and put suffix into that final array that we're returning. So you see down here it printing out its 12 am. If we change this to 12, it prints out its 12 pm. So this is all working as intended. It's 11 pm, works fine. And now for the third subproblem, which is where we have to have those different cases, let's just go ahead and declare a minute object. And then I'm going to go ahead and put that here so we can print out whatever the minute value is. And the first case is if m is less than 10, remember we need to print out the ones array's corresponding mapping value, right? So we can say minute is equal to ones of m. And I'll go ahead and change this to 2301. It says it's 11:01 p.m. So I forgot to put the O here. So now it's printing out it's 11:01 p.m. And then go ahead and test out your edge cases of 09. It's 11:09 p.m. So that's working as intended. If I change this to 10, probably won't work as we want it to because it should print out it's 11:10 p.m. And we haven't implemented that case yet. So let's move on to the second case, which is if m is less than 20, we need to set minute equal to, and then we can say the teens, and then m divided by 10, like we did on the example. Go ahead and close off that curly brace. So now in this case, that's working fine. So it's 11:10 p.m. If I change this to 19, it should print out it's 11:19 p.m. So again, we just implemented case one, which is if it's less than 10. Case two for the teens, if it's less than 20. And then finally, we write the last case, which will be if it's greater than or equal to 20. So we could set minute equal to, and then first we need to do the tens. Again, we floor m divided by 10 here, and that will give us our tens string representation of the tens digit. And then followed by a space, we can do grab the ones array, pass it m mod 10, and that will give us the one string or the ones digit string representation. And then we can test that out here. If we put 2320, it says it's 1120 p.m., so that's good. It's 1129 p.m. when we change this to 29. Change it to 59, it's 1159 p.m. So basically, we've implemented the same solution that we worked on the whiteboard. And kind of as a recap, we declared those four arrays, and we're using those arrays to kind of determine what the string value should be based on the integer values. And we use the index for that mapping. All right, so that wraps up the implementation of the talking clock problem. Again, if you like this tutorial, be sure to like the video and subscribe to Free Code Camp below. All right, thanks for watching.